The course starts by defining sexual harassment in the workplace and explaining how protection comes from both employment law and criminal law, depending on the circumstances. The course will then go on to give some examples of what constitutes unwanted conduct of a sexual nature. We'll also provide examples of sexism at work and how, in some cases, this can be linked to sexual harassment. You'll see from workplace statistics how widespread and serious the problem is, and how the management response to concerns raised is often poor or non-existent. Then we'll look at criminal behaviour. How does it differ from sexual harassment? And can the two be connected? We'll then address how you should deal with historic allegations of sexual harassment, and how employers should be sensitive and fair to the worker who made the complaint, anybody who witnessed it, and anybody who is being accused. You'll learn the correct way to make a complaint of sexual harassment, as well as learning about employers' legal, ethical, and employee relations obligations. Anti-sexual harassment policies are vital, and we'll be looking at them in some detail, as well as looking at organisational policies which lay out the procedures for dealing with any accusations. We'll then talk about the role of the line manager, who's often at the sharp end of sexual harassment claims, and is responsible for communicating the organisation's zero-tolerance approach to members of staff. Handling accusations of sexual harassment can be difficult, and we provided a guide as to how to deal with situations professionally, including how to conduct an investigation, make a decision, and instigate appropriate disciplinary procedures. We'll cover investigation from the employer's perspective, including communicating with staff and keeping accurate records at every stage. You'll discover how the law relates to sexual harassment, along with the role of employment tribunals and the legal rights of the accused to go to appeal. We'll also look at how sexual harassment can be dealt with through your organisation's grievance policy, along with considering sexual harassment from the point of view of the accused. Finally, we'll finish with some case studies, which give further insight into what constitutes harassment and the outcome of cases where the businesses did not act appropriately to deal with this behaviour.